Hi, my name is Patrick. This is for students who are preparing for CAT 23. If you're starting from October 22 and you're preparing for CAT 23, which is roughly 14 months time, how do you go about preparing? What is a broad plan? That's what this video is about. So let's start. I mean, my name is Patrick. I've been training students for CAT exam for the last 20 years, given CAT multiple times, the 6 times CAT 100 percentile, so fairly comfortable with the exam. We are expert in manual entrance preparation, focus on CAT, GPAT, GMAT, IPM, etc. So let's look at the how to prepare. So it's a 4 video series. The first video is a general broad plan regarding how to prepare. Second video will be on mathematics, third video on DILR, and fourth video on verbal, like 4 videos. So let's start with CAT preparation. So broadly 3 sections in the CAT exam. It has been 3 sections for quite some time, so expect it to continue. Verbal, DILR, the DI, data interpretation and logic combined in one section, and the quant, mathematics part. So broadly 3 areas, all 3 are important, equally important. I mean, you may find one more important than the other based on your strengths and weakness, but technically all are as important as the other. So if you're preparing, it makes sense to start preparing with a mock. I mean, you can go to prep.patrick100.com, you'll get a free mock out there. Okay, solve it, you'll get a fair idea about it. So when you start with a mock, you have a fair understanding of the paper pattern. It helps you understand what the paper pattern is all about. Also, you'll come to know the type of question that come in the exam. Because if you look at, there are variations in terms of type of some that come in different exams, specifically in the logic as well as a verbal type. So you will understand the type of question that come in the CAT so that you can then plan your preparation accordingly. Another important thing is you know what your weak and strong areas are. Because in CAT, you need to focus on your weak areas because you need to clear the cutoff. And if you're starting early, it makes sense to focus more on the weak area in the start so that you can overcome it. Weak area takes a longer time to overcome in terms of preparation. So focus on weak area when you're preparing for the exam or planning your preparation. So broadly speaking, first round of preparation starts from October to Jan, I would put it across. I'm putting a shorter target and not putting a longer target so that you can focus and try to complete a syllabus. So try to complete the entire syllabus, just do the basics, not much, but try to complete the entire syllabus during this period, October to Jan 23. Okay, the focus should be to get your fundamentals correct. I mean, don't try to do tougher sums or try to waste a lot of time on individual topic, but the focus here is to get your fundamentals correct, maybe a little more focus on your weaker area, okay, and less focus on your stronger area. So that's what your starting preparation will be. Second round will start from Feb. Once your first round is over, Feb to June, where you go to the entire syllabus again, sort of a revision. But here maybe you will go with the tougher sums as such, okay? Both revising the concept and focusing a little bit more tougher sum than what you did in the first round, right? And try to get meta materials to solve. That the focus will be on the second round. Third round will be focused on mocks. So that means you start from July to November, where the focus will be writing more mocks, focusing on your strategy, trying to figure out where your weak area lies and try to, you know, improve on those areas. So I analyze the mocks out here and identify the areas to improve. We'll come to details of the third round of prep later. In the next videos, we'll focus on the first round of prep extra, how you need to prepare on the first round of preparation. Quant, DILR, and verbal. I hope this is clear. Thank you.